We don't have a physical lab with nuts and bolts as some of the other departments do, because most of what we are dealing with are sort of designed systems rather than physical systems. And we're trying to figure out how to design these systems for sort of maximum effectiveness. So that means that you typically have a certain objective in mind and certain constraints that you want to satisfy.
The research in this department covers, there are two major areas that we cover. One is what's called the stochastic side. These are people who study uncertainty and model that and then apply that. Financial engineering is one area where there's lots of uncertainty, right? You have no idea what the economy is going to do tomorrow, and you have to try to model that uncertainty somehow and make good decisions in the face of that uncertainty. The other major group in this department does optimization really under more certain circumstances. So assuming you do know the data, how do you make the very best decision, you know, given all the variables? And so there's a lot of, you know, computational aspect to that, and again, a modeling aspect and a problem-solving aspect. And so we have two centers in the department, CAP and CORC. CAP is the Center for Applied Probability, and CORC is the Optimization Research Center. Students do participate in research of faculty. I'd say, you know, at any point, there are maybe 10 or so undergraduates who are participating in research.
We have faculty, for example, working on call centers. How should you staff a call center? We have people working in transportation. How should you design roads, and how should you direct traffic so that you can more efficiently serve the population utilizing those resources? We have people doing research on pricing and revenue management, and we have people doing research on supply chain management. And then there are other areas such as scheduling and game theory where people also are working. Now, how do you do that research? Most of the time you start by modeling a situation. And then after you model a situation, you're convinced that you have a realistic model. Then you start to try to prove theorems about the behavior of the system. You're very interested, for example, in how a particular optimal solution may change as you vary some of the parameters. You may be interested in the robustness. How robust is a certain solution to perturbations in the data? And sometimes what we do is we do numerical experiments that sometimes involve solving large-scale mathematical programs or involve doing very detailed simulations. And those experiments are typically carried in computers, in a computer lab.
Students often get involved in doing programming for various faculty members, so there are often ideas that are generated by the faculty and sometimes by the students, and they need to be tested. The students will typically meet with the faculty, say, you know, on a weekly basis, and each time get some particular assignment of what they need to program, and then they'll go off and do it and come back the next week, and hopefully we'll have implemented the idea.
So with the proximity to Wall Street and the various finance courses that we have here, we also allow our students to take courses in the business school, to take courses in the School of International Public Affairs. And this background, not only acquired in our department, but also in various other departments and programs in the university, makes our students, you know, very attractive to recruiters for full-time employment, but also starting this year with summer internships. We actually have been one of the first two departments in the university to partner with the Center for Career Education to provide very rewarding internship programs to our juniors. We decided with career education to provide to our juniors an experience that is not only limited to the internship that they have during the summer, but consists of several courses from January to June before their internship, where they learn things about how to communicate efficiently in a company, how to develop good teamwork, leadership, and initiative skills. Then during the summer internship, we try to interact with the students to get feedback in terms of how they apply these skills to their company environment. And then after the internship, there are two or three sessions where the students meet together and talk about their various experiences, try to share insights, and maybe learn lessons for their full time.
Our students have been very, very successful in obtaining internships. And also, usually during the conclusion of the internships, they actually receive a full-time offer. So, which is actually quite a sigh of relief from them, as well as myself, because they enter their senior year already having a full-time job that they love, and they know what to expect because they've worked there full-time during the summer.